Hey guys, it's Becca. Long time no see. I know I've been MIA for a while, but for good reason. I moved. Brand new place. I'm really excited. So yeah, I'm gonna be telling you my life update slash my fibro updates. So I haven't done a fibro update since probably around November, December-ish. So with that comes hand in hand of my major life change of moving, which I guess I'm gonna try to be as concise and yet not make this video like a million years long. So I had to go to my rheumatologist in January for a follow-up, and I found out that my new insurance does not cover my rheumatologist. So basically all that hard work of trying to get my doctors together and try to figure out what's going on was a complete waste of time because my insurance does not take any of my doctors at that clinic. So I had to find another doctor. I went to my general practitioner and she prescribed me gabapentin because I was having really bad issues with my back. And she referred me to another doctor, and the doctor that I went to, she was pretty good. I'm talking as in like past tense, but she did a full comprehensive x-rays of my back, which was awesome because my old rheumatologist didn't even want to bother. It was just, he was looking at x-rays from when I went to urgent care for my, when I originally was diagnosed with arthritis. So she doesn't really prescribe Amarex very much, and so she took me off of that, and she let me choose, because she said she prescribes Flexeril, and Flexeril doesn't really work very much for me, but it helps me sleep. So I was like, okay, you know what, I'll go on it. And so she also doesn't prescribe Effexor apparently. So Effexor is really dangerous to get off of because of withdrawal side effects. So I have to go to my general practitioner so she can help me wean off of that. So that was kind of disappointing because she doesn't really understand or really prescribe Flexeril that much, not Flexeril, Effexor that much. So that was kind of a letdown. But on the bright side, she definitely said that I do have fibromyalgia, which is kind of obvious at this point. And after I got the x-rays back of my comprehensive back x-rays, I definitely do have mild arthritis, but also she found my discs were inflamed, my S1 disc area. So, and she also sent me for blood work, and the blood work actually showed that there is inflammation going on in my system, so she sent me for an MRI. And in the midst of all this, pretty much the doctor's appointment, I'm trying to figure out how I can, like, incorporate how I, so pretty much this was in January when she sent me for x-rays, and at that time, I was looking for new places, but I wasn't expecting to move as quick as I did. So, when we found a place that we really liked, it was kind of like we had to move quick because they wanted us to move in like March otherwise. I mean, we could have put the deposit down and all that, but anyways, so I wound up moving March 26th, so the last like little minor clip video that I made, I knew I was moving, but I think a week later, that's when I found out where I was moving. So I am between like, was it January or February? I honestly can't remember at this time, but in the process, I didn't have much time to really kind of get my things together. I was kind of basically just rushing as I was trying to get ready to move. And with that comes fibro flare-ups. So the first week I moved in, I know that I'm probably going all over the place, but afterwards you'll understand. And I didn't find out that I had to go for an MRI until like the first week I moved in. So basically the first week that we moved in, I was in a constant flare-up, but I wasn't as bad until I officially moved into this place. The first day, I could have relaxed a little bit if I wanted to, but I didn't want to be living out of boxes. So, I had to rest at one point, and there wasn't really much space for me to rest, so I just kind of went into a downward dog position when I was in the bedroom, after I was, like, going in and out of the bathroom, and, I was in a lot of pain, and I decided, you know what, I'll go to the living room, and I'll sit down for a little bit, and the pain was really bad. We wound up going out to lunch or dinner that day, and we also had to go to Target and pick up some stuff. And when I got out of the car, I almost fell. I've been having balancing issues really badly lately. I wish I could. This update is going to be with my fibro. I wish that it could be better, but unfortunately, it's just been getting worse. And that's partially my fault, but at the same time, so the first week was basically hell on my back. There were times where I almost, if I sat down, I couldn't get up, and when I did get up, I almost fell. Like I said, I've been having major balancing issues lately. So, and then after that week, when I found out I had to go for the MRI, my rheumatologist put me on prednisone, so I wound up taking the prednisone after I got the MRI done, and she put me on 12 days worth. Prednisone is not something to be reckoned with, and it really didn't help. The only thing it made me do was it made me really hungry, really nauseous, and it made me really angry. So pretty much people that I care about and people that in general, I mean, I tried to stay away from people because I knew I was going to say things that I didn't mean, and I didn't want to hurt them or upset them. So I did my best to avoid society at all costs. I mean, I had to work at times because, you know, you have to go to work, but I did. The thing is I knew that the side effects are really nasty, especially with moods. So there were times when I just had to kind of regroup myself and just keep telling myself, this is not you, it's the medication. You can just, you know, I managed to just psychologically just keep myself in check, even though it was really hard at times. And I was emotional. I've been emotional because it's getting worse. The prednisone did not help the pain, and it was really disappointing, because I went through all that and it didn't do anything. It made me functional for a little bit, but it didn't. I'm not walking as well as I was for those few days. And it's just been constantly, I don't know how I'm going to feel each day, and especially with the medications lately, I've been nauseous almost every single day or every other day or whatever. So, to prepare myself, I always have little mints in my bag now, and it kind of helps with the nausea, and I don't have my MRI review until next Monday, which sucks. I had to reschedule because the doctor was out of the office. So I'm assuming that because it wasn't serious, if it was serious, she would have probably called me by now. So in most recent updates, I also found out, or I kind of figured out on my own, that I have arthritis in my hips. And I was gonna film yesterday, but I had to kind of rest because I was just really exhausted from the night before. So with the move, I have been really kind of busting my butt trying to get everything in and settled, and that does trigger my flare-ups. So I remember somebody asking me if what I do to treat my flare-ups, and honestly, I haven't been doing much. I haven't been gluten-free lately because I've been, you know, it's no excuse, but at the same time, when I'm trying to get things done, sometimes things take priority over my body, and I know that I should be taking care of myself better. So, but on days that I do have really bad flare-ups, I have a shower chair. And thank you to everybody that made really nice and positive comments on my Instagram. You know, some people that know that I have a shower chair are just kind of like, really? You're using it? you know, they think that I'm too young to, you know, have these issues, and they really kind of don't understand. But the shower chair really does help. But at the same time, when I have a really bad flare-up, if I'm in the shower, it feels like the water is like BB pellets hitting my skin. So I can't win either way at times. But lately, that problem hasn't been so bad. So this is Monday night, and I went out to lunch with my aunts. I scrubbed the house. I was feeling pretty good for the first time in a while. So I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna just totally go with it. So I scrubbed the apartment down a little bit, and excuse me, my aunts came over and we went out to lunch, and then I went food shopping because I had to really go food shopping, and I cooked dinner. So by the time I was done cooking dinner, well, I was in the middle of cooking dinner, my hip decided that it didn't want to work. So my right hip, it didn't feel so good. I was limping around, but I'm like, whatever, I don't care. And my back was hurting. Turned out it was actually gonna rain, which I didn't realize. And that's how I kind of figured out I had arthritis in my hip. My hip just, my right hip was in unbearable pain. And when I was done with the dishes, I was still walking around because I wanted to, you know, I wanted something else to eat other than dinner. I was trying to just straighten up, and I almost fell. I couldn't walk on my right side, and it was really frustrating. So my boyfriend helped me to the bedroom, and I climbed into bed. And I was laying down for a little bit, and my body just kind of completely tensed up. And it was just so bad that I couldn't walk. I couldn't move. And anytime I moved, I was in constant pain. It was my back. It was my hips. And it was just really frustrating. I actually wound up breaking down and crying because I still had things I wanted to do, and I was frustrated with my body at the same time. So I couldn't brush my teeth. I couldn't go and brush my teeth. I had to brush my teeth in bed. And if I had to get up and go to the bathroom, my boyfriend literally took this chair, put it right next to the bed, and helped me get into it, and then would wheel me to the bathroom. It was really frustrating. So, I'm not gonna lie, I've had a bit of an emotional roller coaster with this, but I am trying to stay strong. I actually had another doctor's appointment last week with my gynecologist. She's impressed. She's really impressed with me because, she asked me, she's like, oh, would you ever consider going on disability? I'm not ready to go on disability yet. I'm a workaholic, and I don't care. I will do what it takes. I will basically just push through any pain I'm going through, and I work through it. And I really need to stop doing that and take care of my body more, obviously. But I'm not ready for it, and I'm waiting to see what the MRI will have to say, and we'll take it from there. I'm also going off my birth control because I'm having some issues, so she wants to see if, you know, one of my problems is being caused by my birth control. So I know this is a little scattered, and if you guys have sat through this, I appreciate it very much. I honestly don't know what to say. That's pretty much what I've been going through, and I'm still keeping my head up. I'm not letting this get to me. I'm kind of frustrated. I'm almost 30, and I can't walk by myself right now. I mean, I'm doing better than I was on Monday night. I'm walking with a limp right now, and I'll talk to my rheumatologist on Monday also about this issue. She might want to take an x-ray of my hip just to confirm, but I'm pretty sure at this point. And since I climb stairs, I didn't realize that arthritis and stairs on my hips are just not a good combo. So I have to kind of minimize stair climbing and just try to take it easy right now. I'm not gonna give up. I'm gonna keep going through this. And I don't have any issues with people that go on disability, but for me right now, I'm gonna keep working through this. I'm gonna try to find ways of trying to give my body comfort while I still trek along. So if you have, I seem nervous. It's just, this is not the update that I really wanted to give you guys. I wanted to give you guys something more positive, and but I do appreciate your support. You guys mean a lot to me, and thank you for watching. And if you watch this video in the entirety and you have no idea who I am, my name is Becca. I have fibromyalgia, and I also have arthritis. I'm recording this for you know, the friends that I made on here, as well as myself, you know, to help kind of research fibromyalgia more. So I know I'm saying a lot. You know, since we don't really know much about this disorder, and we're trying to figure out, oh, by the way, my mother was talking about, for all my fibro friends, my mom was talking to another family member, she's not blood related, but apparently she had mono, and she has fibromyalgia too. I had mono about, almost 11 years ago, which is kind of really scary. I was in my first semester of college, and brings back some good memories, but at the same time, I had mono. So, and I, some people think that mono actually triggers fibromyalgia, so just something to keep in mind about that. And yeah, so that is my update for you guys. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe, and I hope everybody has a great day. Bye.